Let's do an example where we're going to reduce this fraction, 28 over 63, by using the prime factorization method. So we'll start with the top and we'll look at 28. So let's make its prime factorization. So we can start by dividing by any prime number. I can pretty clearly divide by 2, but you can also divide by anything that you see that is a prime number. So 7 is also a prime number, and I can see that that comes out as well. So unlike the other examples, I'm going to start with dividing by 7 and not 2. So if I divide 28 by 7, I'll be left with 4. So I keep this 7 off to the side, and now I work with the 4. So now the 4 breaks down into 2 and 2, and I can't go any further, so this is my prime factorization here. I've got 7 times 2 times 2. So now if we look at 63, again, let's do a prime factorization, and I know that 7 also divides into 63. So if I put a 7 here, that leaves me with a 9. So now I keep the 7 for later, and I break up the 9 further, and that's a 3 and a 3. I can't go any further, so I leave that as 3 and 3. So now 28 over 63 I can rewrite as 7 times 2 times 2 divided by 7 times 3 times 3. So now we just compare and we cross off things that are in common, and the only thing common here is the 7. And it also turns out that the greatest common factor between these two numbers is also the 7. So what's left over here now is 2 times 2 is 4 in the top, and in the bottom I have 3 times 3 is 9, and that is my reduced answer. Now let's look at another example of reducing a fraction using prime factorization. So we're going to start with 70. So again, I can divide by any prime number. 70 is easily divisible by 7, so I'm going to do 7 and 10. We'll keep the 7 for later, and then break down the 10. So 10 is 2 times 5, and that's as far as we can go. So there's our prime factorization, 7 times 2 times 5. 92, this one's a little bit trickier, but I can tell it's even, so I'm going to start by dividing by 2 just to make it into a smaller number. So 92 divided by 2, that's going to give me 46. So I keep the 2 off to the side, and then I'm going to work more with the 46. 46, that's also even, so I'm going to pull out another 2, just divide out by whatever prime numbers you can, and that leaves me with a 23. And 23 is actually a prime number as well, so that's where we can stop here. So now rewriting the fraction, the 70 is 7 times 2 times 5 over 2 times 2 times 23. So not a whole lot in common here, top to bottom, but I am allowed to get rid of 1, 2 each. So now in the top I have 7 times 5, which is left, gives me 35, and on the bottom I have 2 times 23, which is 46. So there is my reduced final answer.